Have you ever heard of the element of carbon? Did you know that there are four forms of carbon? Can you name those four forms for me? I can give you some hints. One form you use every day in school. That's right. It's graphite. It's found in everyday pencils. Another form of carbon is usually found in jewelry, in engagement rings. It's called a diamond. This is the same form, diamond and graphite. But how do they differ? It's all in the structure. This is a single sheet of graphite. Graphite forms in a two-dimensional sheet in hexagon pattern. When they're stacked together, they have weaker bonds holding them together, like you see in this model. Now graphite, the form of graphite in two-dimensional sheets and weaker bonds gives it this nice flexibility. And that's how you can see graphite when you write with your pencil. Each sheet on the weaker bonds gets left behind. Another interesting fact about graphite is that it conducts electricity. What we have here to show you that is an LED strip with a battery mounted to it in the inside of this box. And I have a double sharpened pencil. If I attach this wire to this side of the pencil, and this wire to this side of the pencil, the LED strip should light up. Let's see what happens. The next form of carbon is diamond. Just like graphite was formed in a two-dimensional sheet, diamond is different. It's formed three-dimensionally. Each carbon atom is connected with these bonds, rigid bond, to each other one in four different directions. This gives it a strength that it doesn't exist within the graphite. You can squeeze this and it doesn't move. So one thing that diamonds are good for is then the tools. They're the hardest surface, hardest known material on Earth. This is a diamond scribe. And the very tip of this scribe is a diamond. And on that, with that diamond, you can use this to scratch materials that are harder than normal, like a piece of glass. Let's first try to mark on this glass with a regular graphite pencil. It doesn't seem to leave a mark. Now let's try with this diamond scribe. It left its mark. Now it left its mark because its structure, the structure of the diamond model, is the same as it is in the tip, and it's harder than the structure of the glass surface. Another form of carbon that I want to introduce you to is the buckyball. It looks very similar to something else that you may be more familiar with. That's right, a soccer ball. One area of research that scientists are using buckyballs is in the medicinal transport. What they're doing is taking medicines and attaching them into the inside of the buckyball and using the buckyball as a cage and a transport to send through your body into the spot that it hurts. The reason why it's called a buckyball, though, is because it is named after Buckminster Fuller, an architect who also was exploring the geometric dome. Another form, and our last form of carbon, is the carbon nanotube. This is a model of a metallic carbon nanotube, but it only gets that name, the name of the shape of metallic, from its form, its structure as well. Just like there are different forms of carbon, there are different forms of nanotubes as well. To illustrate this, we use a sheet of hexagons that looks very similar to the sheet of graphite. When you roll the sheet up in one direction, it gives you one form of a nanotube. If you can see the shape here, this is the armchair form, all because of that shape. Now when you take that same sheet and twist it 90 degrees, roll it back up, you get a different shape. This is the shape you get, and this is called a zigzag. The last shape you get is when you take that same sheet and coil it up so you get this shape here. This is a chiral. So seeing that the nanotube is a rolled up sheet of graphite, it also conducts electricity. And scientists think that the nanotube can conduct electricity faster than what exists today. These are half-inch ball bearings. In our representation, they are electrons. On the left-hand side, we have a carbon nanotube. And on the right-hand side, we have a normal copper wire. Which one was going to get down to the end first? Your mark, get set, go. You guessed right. The nanotube was the winner. The reason why it was a winner, and the reason why the copper wasn't a winner, was its choices. On the nanotube, there's only one path or two paths, or a very limited path that which it can take to go to the other end. On the copper wire, there are multiple choices the electron has to make to get to the end. I've showed you four forms of carbon today. Graphite, diamond, nanotube, and a buckyball.